Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've seen it. Either way, I made the decision, and I think it worked out extremely well for us. I'm very pleased with this decision, and I think it's going to lead to something that is going to be great for me, possibly contending for a title next season. Heck, maybe I can get into the fight this season, depending on how we develop the car going forward. Although I think I'm still going to cancel or wrap up whatchamacallit, research and development after Monza. So we'll see. Like I said, we'll see how that works out for us. Overall, I think it will be a lot of fun to do and interesting, to say the least. So I'm going to leave it up to the announcers now, and I'll let you guys enjoy this race.
Anthony Davidson, a man who made his Grand Prix debut here with Minardi back in 2002. So, Ants, this is a bit of a special one for you, I'd imagine.
Yeah, I'd say so. I also stood in to commentate on Jensen's win in 2006, and as I was a test driver for Honda at the time, you can imagine that was quite an emotional Grand Prix. It's also a tough circuit on the drivers, this one, too. Lots of long, slow corners that require a lot of patience from inside the car. Plus, it's a very downforce-heavy circuit. I mean, it's all relative, of course, but if you're lacking a bit in downforce, or if you've got a bit of an imbalance in the setup, this is definitely one of the worst places to have to deal with that.
You're above where we expected on the grid. Be careful not to lose places, as there will be faster cars around you.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, with Nico Rosberg alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have a Ferrari, Raikkonen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Verstappen, Grosjean, Kvyat, Hülkenberg, and Sergio Perez, Massa, Alonso, Esteban Gutierrez, and Sainz, Magnussen, Harry Anto, Jolyon Palmer, and Jenson Button, Bottas, and Wehrlein, Marcus Ericsson, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Thank you.
is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. an issue with their car, they're going to be slow. Thank you. box, box. distance to teammate, 13.6 seconds. Rosberg's in first place.
Thank you.
down to our teammate is 6.2 seconds. Six seconds. two stops left in this strategy. We have two stops planned. cars. They're coming back up to speed.
Win then for the Mercedes team today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. It's a good result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Oh, well, I'm a bit spoilt for choice, Crofty. My instinct says Valtteri Bottas, and looking down the field, no one really jumps out at me to make me change my mind.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Well, that was not the debut we were hoping for. I made the wrong strategy call. That's all I know is I went with the wrong tires at the wrong time, and it just didn't work for us. So, that's something to take into account next race, and we'll look at it. We're going to move on to Germany, and our goal is to hopefully pass Sebastian. That seems like an easy goal, so that's my goal for the next couple races, is to get past Vettel and show Ferrari that they did make the right decision in offering me his ride, which is odd because he literally just won Silverstone, which is funny because Nico won today and he deserved to win Silverstone. But hey, I don't know. Like I said, we'll move on. I doubt we're going to be able to make any upgrades, especially since I want to save some for either drag or engine power going to Silver or Spa, knowing that that is that kind of track. So we'll see what we can get out of it. And so we lose on that. Oh geez, But we're good on that. Oh, God. So we actually lost one overall. Oh, wow. The team has not touched drag at all. Yeah, we're probably going to do that first, considering they haven't touched it at all. And drag has been so useful for the Haas cars that we had. So we'll probably end up with that as our next thing. Let's see who makes the changes this week and what we can do to get better. Now, 16 points behind Verstappen. So we'll need to step up our game on that one. All right, welcome to Germany, ladies and gentlemen. And there are no research to be talked about. All right then. Well, I guess we're gonna just head out for practice, and I'll see you guys for the race. I hope you've enjoyed it.